Hello everyone. In this lecture, we will learn about the LEX tool. LEX tool is a very important tool with respect to the compiler. If you want to design your own compiler, in that case, the lexical analyzer part of your program will be written, or lexical analyzer part of your compiler will be written in the LEX tool. So as you can see that it is a tool that generates the lexical analyzer. So you must be knowing that the lexical analyzer is a kind of the scanner which takes the input characters that you have written in the program, and it converts them into the stream of the tokens. For example, if we have the expression of kind A equals to B plus C multiplied with D, in that case it will find out what are the different types of the tokens here. And after the identification, it will list them out and will store those things into the sim table. For example, here in this expression, we have the identifiers A, B, C, and D. Then we have the operator symbols equals to plus multiplication, and then the punctuation symbol, that is the semicolon. So LEX is an utility to help you rapidly generate your scanners. It means if you want to design your own compiler, then in that case, for the lexical analyzer part, for writing the lexical analyzer part, you will make use of the LEX tool. Let us take another example to understand the role of the lexical analyzer in the compiler design. Let's say we have a sentence, if x is greater than 3.1. So this is the sentence in a given, or this is the instruction given in the particular program, and we have to do the lexical analysis on this. So the character stream will be provided as an input to the lexical analyzer, and the lexical analyzer will produce the stream of the tokens. For example, in this sentence we have different kind of the tokens. One is the keyword, which is if, the identifier, which is x, the operator symbols, which are greater than sign, opening parenthesis and the closing parenthesis, and a constant 3.1. So the lexical analyzer has listed them out and produces as an output the stream of the tokens. Now let us understand about the LEX programs. If we have to write the LEX program will have the three sections. One is the declarations section, another one is the translation rules, and another one is the auxiliary functions, and all these are separated by the percentage. So double percentage is put in between these three sections just to segregate the different parts. So as you can see here that the LEX source is separated into three sections by percentage delimiters. The general format of the LEX source is the three portions: declarations, translation rules, and auxiliary functions, all three separated by the percentage. Out of these parts, the first two parts are compulsory parts, but the third part is the optional one. It means you may write the auxiliary function, write the auxiliary functions, or you may skip that also. The absolute minimum LEX program is percentage. The declaration sections includes declaration of variables. The translation rules have the following form, like pattern, and then followed by the action. It means in the translation form, what we will say, that if this pattern appears and this is the output. For example, if you've already defined the pattern for the identifiers, so in the pattern we will write identifier, and in the action part we will write the what is the action, means what we have to return actually. Okay, return means that whatever is the output is the return of this. The third section holds whatever auxiliary function are used in the action. Since we are going to apply some action, for that action we will have to write those functions. So those functions are written here in the auxiliary function part. The LEX program will take or we will write the LEX program and save that program with the .l extension. So whatever code you have written in the LEX, you will have to save that with .l extension. The LEX compiler will convert that in lex.yy.c format, And then internally in the lex tool itself, it will be converted as to the a.out with the help of the C compiler. It means lex compiler is producing a file which is which is used as an input to the C compiler, and then the output file is converted. So what you will do with the output, you know it well, that whenever you deal with the exe files, those have the output file as well as an extension in which you provide some input and the output is produced. So similarly here we have already written the lex program. So if output file has been generated, you will provide the input stream to that, and correspondingly the output is generated, which is the sequence of the tokens. So you can see here also an input file which we call lex.l is written in the lex language and describes the lexical analyzer to be generated. The lex compiler transforms lex.l program to the C program in a file that is always named as lex.yy.c. So lex is the name of your file, and then the extension is yy.c. The latter file is compiled by the C compiler into a file called a.out. The C compiler output is a working lexical analyzer that can take a stream of input characters and produce a stream of tokens. So the output file which has been generated by the C program is actually your lexical analyzer, in which you will provide the input and it will generate a sequence of the tokens. Fine. Now here is the translation rules, in which there are two parts. One is the pattern and the other one is the action part. So in the pattern part, you will write which kind of the pattern you are expecting. For example, 0 to 9 plus means there is a pattern that there will be digits, any digit in between 0 to 9 or its combination. Fine. So minimum there should be one digit which has been guaranteed, and the same has been depicted in the different format under the curly braces. Fine. And the action part is that we want to return the integer. So this is the action: return integer. So these are some of the regular expression basics. Dot means matches any single character except \n, and the star sign, it means zero or more instances of the preceding regular expression. So all these basics are known by you. We are just having a look at these symbols once again. And these symbols can be used there in the lex program directly. Plus means, if let's say we are writing a star, it means that it may take epsilon as well, or any combination of a, single a, double a, three a's. But if you are writing a plus, it means it has to contain at least one a. Okay, so at least one a, and maybe any combination of the a. But if a star is there, it may also contain epsilon. Now the question mark symbol says that if any expression is written just before the question mark, so that has either to be considered or that may not be considered also. For example, if you have a number, so that if that number is positive, we do not need to write the plus symbol before that. But if a number is negative, we have to write the negative symbol before that. So plus and minus is optional. Okay, it is not necessary that before every number you should write plus and minus. So the question mark is actually taken as an optional part. The standing line, which actually matches the preceding or the following regular expression, it means if you are providing A, then a standing line B means you either have to take A or B. This defines the class of the character. Characters, it means what are the different characters which are going to appear that will be represented in the form of the square brackets. For example, A to Z. So if we write A to Z in between the square brackets, it means it may take any value, or the class of the characters are in between A to Z. So this actually is used for, parenthesis is used to combine the regular expressions. If you have one regular expression, we have to combine it with another regular expressions. and we have to keep it together, then we are using this parenthesis. And then dot 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 matches everything with the within the double quotes. So the double quotes, it is not about the dot dot dot. Whatever is written in between the double quotes, this will be taken. It means definitely we have to we have no choice of taking one symbol or two symbol. Everything written in between the double quotes should match. Okay, these are the regular expression examples. X oblique y means, or x standing line y means x or y. Under curly brackets, I means we are defining I. X slash y means x only if followed by y. Okay, x under bracket, x under curly brackets, m and n, m to n occurrences of x. Fine. So x may appear either m times, or n plus 1 times, or n plus 2 times, up to n times. For example, if I am writing it like x under the curly braces 2 comma 4, so it means x may either appear 2 times, or it may appear 3 times, or it may appear 4 times. The upper cap x, that means x has to appear in the beginning of the line, and x dollar means x has to appear at the end of the line. And double quotes s means everything that is there in the double quotes. We have already discussed about this, that s may be any string, so exact match has to be there. Now regular expression examples. For an integer 1 2 3 4 5, it has to start with 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9. Anything in between this, a number cannot start with a zero. Okay, so first 1 to 9, then followed by any combination of 0 to 9. So that's why 1 to 9, then 0 to 9 star. A word. Word means any English letter word. Okay, so the English letter word, English language word will contain anything between A to small a to small z and capital A to capital Z. But in a word, there should be at least one character. So that's why a plus is there. A number which may either be positive or negative. So this, the minus or plus sign is the optional one. That's why a question mark after minus and plus. And then a number, a digit 1 to 9 or 0 to 9 combination. So this we have already seen, that if this is the integer number, positive or negative, in that case the regular expression is, the first regular expression is for that only. The last one, a floating point number. In floating point number there will always be a dot. Okay, so if you see in the regular expression, in between we have under the double quotes a dot, so dot has to be there. Before the dot, it may be anything, any combination of the digits. It may be zero also. So any combination of 0 to 9, and then followed by at least one letter, at least one number, or at least one digit. So that's why 0 to 9 plus. Now this is the sample Lex program. In this program, the first one is letter. In the declaration part, there are three parts. The blue line statements are not to be written. We have just written it to make you clear about what are the different parts. First part is the declaration part, in which you have defined that anything that is in between capital A to capital Z and a small a to small z is a letter. And then anything that is in between 0 to 9 is a digit. Then the ID is the identifier. So what will be an identifier? Identifier is the combination of letter and the digits, but it will always start with the letter. And then it is actually not the complete one, but in our language or in our Lex program, we are going to define this as an identifier, because in an identifier there can be an underscore as well. so that we have not written it here. It also varies with the program to program, or it also varies from the language to language. But for the particular language, we are going to define the lexical analyzer. In that, the underscore is not included. Now, what is the integer number? An integer number is it is actually the unsigned integer number, which will either contain one digit or more than one digit. And a real number, which actually contains at least one digit before dot, and then a dot, sorry, any digit after the dot, any number of digit after the dot. Fine. And then this is the translation part, in which on the left hand side we have written that which is to be matched, and once the match has been found, what action is required to be taken. So if we have identified if, that is a keyword, so we have to return if. If we identify else, we have to return else. If we identify any identifier, so in that case, just leave the first part, which is written in the action part, YYL value equals to int install id. Just look at this next part, which is written in the red. It is about return id, because we have found an identifier. And then if we have identified an integer number, we have to return integer number. If we have found a real number, we have to return the real number. So on the left hand side, a pattern is observed. On the right hand side, we are doing what action is required to be taken. So input, corresponding to the input, we have to produce some output. So these are the outputs. And in the auxiliary functions, we will have to write the definition of the functions that we have used in the action part. You just see that we have used some function install id, install number in the action part. So we will have to write the definition of these two functions here in the auxiliary function part. These are the predefined variables in the lex: yy text, yy leng, yy in, yy out. If you just read out, what are these? A string containing the lexeme, the length of the lexeme, yy len, yy in, input stream pointer, yy out, the output stream pointer. These are some of the lex routine, lex library routines: yy lex, yy more, yy less, under bracket n, yy warp. Thank you.